Albay 2nd District Representative Joey Salceda is convinced Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte is looking to follow in her father's footsteps. Salceda, a supporter of Mayor Duterte, maintains his conversations with the younger Duterte point to a 2022 presidential run. But the Albay lawmaker doesn't see the daughter sharing top billing with the father. He believes the Davao mayor would be better served to get someone who can represent other regions.
Aside from the geographical balance na kailangan, you don't see it happening because you think the president won't agree?
Ah, yes. I think ayaw ka naman pangunahan si Presidente Duterte.
Yeah.
Tsaka mas pipiliin niya, although she's been saying na huwag ka dyan, Sara, but I think the people are already starting to speak. She's been 26% for something. Surveys ready.
Salceda notes Mayor Sara is looking to form alliances and there's no lack of potential allies.
Lahat naman galing diretso sa kanya eh. Sa chat. I think 2 weeks ago I already said that, diba? So there was nothing new. Sabi niya, sabi ko di, I was a bit ano, kasi after some people started to confirm it with her, I think all of you will receive an answer of no comment. So, paano yan, ma'am? Sabi ko, ang dami kong media interview. Okay lang yan kung, sabi ko, ma'am, hindi naman ako nagsabi na that's not my intention. Hindi, okay lang. Sabi ko, in our direct word, ikaw na muna. But if you look at the body language and the mere fact that from sources, I know that there are at least 5 political parties that are ready. In other words, there are alliances being built to support their candidacy.
On Thursday, former Defense Secretary Gilbert Teodoro personally visited Duterte in Davao to greet her on her birthday. He was accompanied by former Camarines Sur Representative Rolando Andaya Jr., who envisions a Duterte-Teodoro tandem for 2022. Andaya even posted a photo of himself and Teodoro on their flight to Davao with the caption, "Done deal."
Yung done deal na sinasabi ko, sa isip ko yun. Dahil itong tandem na to, napaniginipan ko lang yun na mangyayari to at nangyari na.
Andaya is confident it's just a matter of time before it becomes official. Even though the Davao mayor has previously said she has no plans of running next year.
Tingin ko malapit na. Hindi na abuti ng isang buwan. Ano ba ngayon? June na, no? July. Tingin ko hindi lalampas ng July. Hindi lalampas ng July. Magpa-box office na yan.
Teodoro, who ran but lost to Noynoy Aquino in the 2010 presidential polls, hinted at a political comeback in his Facebook post. He highlighted his qualities as he made a reference to 2022. Over the weekend, it was defeated Vice Presidential candidate Bongbong Marcos, who visited the presidential daughter with his sister, Senator Aimee Marcos, for a pre-birthday lunch. The Marcoses said politics was not on the menu. Presidential spokesperson Harry Roque says the president is against his daughter seeking the seat in Malacañang, but he is open to supporting her possible presidential run. Aside from Mayor Sara, Roque said Duterte has 4 other people in mind as potential successors. His longtime aide, Senator Christopher Goh, former Senator Ferdinand Marcos, Senator and boxer Manny Pacquiao, and Manila Mayor Isko Moreno. But this early progressive group, Makabayan Bloc, objected to the possibility of a father and daughter running for the highest national posts. This comes after the ruling political party PDP called on the president to seek the vice presidency. If this happens, Makabayan says it will be the first dynastic succession in the presidency.
Sa 2022 elections, hindi tayo papayag na mailuklok ang mag-amang Duterte na magpapanatili ng baluktot, pasista at anti-mamamayang pamamalakad na nagdulot ng matinding kahirapan sa gitna ng pandemya.
RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.